गुड मॉर्निंग डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट इन नेक्स्ट सेगमेंट इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ क्लिनिकल एग्जामिनेशन इन ऑर्थोपेडिक प्रैक्टिस, दैट इज एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ इल्बो ज्वाइंट. द इल्बो ज्वाइंट इज ए फ्रीली मूवेबल ज्वाइंट विथ दीज डिस्टिंक्ट आर्टिकुलेशन. आर्टिकुलेशंस आर ह्यूमेरो अल्नर ज्वाइंट, ह्यूमेरो रेडियल ज्वाइंट, सुपेरियर रेडियो अल्नर ज्वाइंट. सो दीज थ्री ज्वाइंट्स यूनाइट एंड फॉर्म द इल्बो ज्वाइंट. ह्यूमेरो अल्नर ज्वाइंट, ह्यूमेरो रेडियल ज्वाइंट, सुपेरियर रेडियो अल्नर ज्वाइंट. द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ द इल्बो कंसिस्ट of history, inspection and physical examination. In history, a patient of elbow disorder usually complain of pain, stiffness and deformity. Pain in the elbow could be due to disorder of the elbow joint or could be a referred pain. Pain in the elbow joint due to disorder of the elbow joint or referred pain from the neck or shoulder. True elbow pain usually does not extend to the forearm or hand, whereas pain from the neck usually radiate below the elbow. In intra-articular problems, the patient complains of pain all over the joint, especially in cases of arthritis. In extra-articular problem, pain is usually localized to one area as follows: medial side, lateral side, posterior side or anterior aspect. Medial side pain indicate the medial epicondylitis, swelling or inflammation or overgrowth in epicondyles. This condition present in golfer's elbow. In case of golfer's elbow, medial epicondyle has pain or medial epicondylitis. Lateral side, lateral epicondylitis, tennis elbow. Posterior aspect, olecranon bursitis in case of student's elbow. Anterior aspect or bicipital radial bursitis. So it is important to determine the character and location of the pain, activities that participate or aggravate or relieve the symptoms should be carefully recorded. Stiffness and loss of movements. Elbow joint is notorious to develop stiffness and loss of movement early. Trauma. Most of the elbow disorder in children and young adult are due to trauma. Fall from height or road traffic accident or RTA are the usual causes. Supracondylar fracture of humerus, fracture head of the radius and posterior dislocation of the elbow are some of the well-known problems in this group. Deformity. Patient with elbow deformity usually give a history of childhood injury mismanaged or treated by an osteopath. Inspection. The physical examination of the elbow joint begins with a systemic inspection of the joint and extremities. Palpation. In palpation, we see following points: local temperature, tenderness, local temperature will be raised in arthritis and bursitis. Tenderness, the sight of tenderness can give clue to diagnose the case. All over the joint, if tenderness in all over the joint may be arthritis, overall epicondyle, over lateral epicondyle, tennis elbow, over medial epicondyle, golfer's elbow, over olecranon process, student's elbow, over cubital fossa, bicipitoradial bursitis, over radial head, fracture head of radius. Bony landmark. Bony landmarks on the lateral side, the most important bony landmark is the lateral epicondyle. The radial head is palpable approximately 3 cm distal to the lateral epicondyle and is best palpated by holding the elbow in slight flexion and simultaneously rotating the fora. The most prominent part on the medial side is the medial epicondyle. Just proximal to it is the medial supracondylar ridge. Just posterior to the medial epicondyle is the ulnar notch of the humerus, where ulnar nerve can be palpated. Swelling due to effusion can be easily palpated in the region of bordered by lateral epicondyle. Palpate the lower end of humerus, upper end of the radius and ulna for any bony thickening. Palpate the supracondylar and axillary lymph nodes. Movements. Elbow movement should be recorded and measured after completion of inspection and palpation. Elbow movement are flexion and extension and rotation. Flexion. Range elbow flexion is measured from the fully extended position to about 140 degree to 150 degree and this is recorded as 0 degree to 140 degree. Prime movers. Biceps. Brachialis, brachioradialis. Extension. Normal is natural or 0 degree. Prime mover are triceps and acuneus. Supination or pronation method. The patient is seated, arm is placed firmly by side, the elbow is held at 90 degree and the thumb is straight up. Muscle supination. Prime mover are biceps supinator. Accessory muscle are brachioradialis. Pronation. Prime movers are pronator quadratus and pronator teres. Accessory muscle are flexor carporadialis. Measurement. Limb length measurement. The length of the entire upper limb should be measured and compared to the normal side. Muscle wasting or wasting of muscle. Make the identical points on the upper arm and forearm on both sides and measure the girth of the muscle. Deformity estimation as cubitus, varus or valgus. Flexion deformity. a special test. Has Cogent test, affected elbow is slightly flexed and pronated. The patient is instructed to make a first and actively dorsiflex the hand and wrist against full resistance. If this produces pain at or near the lateral epicondyle, it is suggestive of tennis elbow. Golfer's elbow. The elbow is in slight flexion. The hand and wrist of the patient is in supination. A steady pressure is applied to the supinated hand in an attempt to extend the elbow. The patient resists this movement with active flexion. If pain is elicited at the medial epicondyle, it suggests golfer elbow. Important elbow disorders: quietal varus deformity, posterior dislocation elbow, fracture of radial head, tennis elbow, golfer's elbow, olecranon bursitis, TB elbow, rheumatoid arthritis, myositis ossificans traumatica of the upper limb causing ankylosis of the elbow is a rare entity. This specific cause for myositis and its morphology remain unclear. Proliferation of connective tissue occurs after a muscle injury that differentiate into mature bone. So this is about examination of elbow. Thank you for watching. Like, share and subscribe.